I'm Mrs. Sunita Dhur and my colleague. This is Trupti Indi from Walter Institute of Technology, Solapur, Maharashtra. And our presentation topic is HBL for effective implementation of problem statement during the lab session. Lab-based learning encourages active learning, effective decision making, improve critical thinking, and when working in a small group, can further develop students' cooperative skills. So, the practical work motivates the student, inspires their interest in the course, enhances their understanding about the course, improves their problem analyzing and solving skill, bridges the gap between teaching and understanding the course, concentrate on the fundamentals and its application, etc. Various active cooperative learning methods are practiced in the teaching learning process to engage the students in activity-based or the problem-based learning and motivate them to enhance their understanding about the course. There are a number of ways to enhance the laboratory environment. So it is also possible by integrating theory with the practice and blending other active learning strategies such as think pair share, team pair solo, flipped classroom, etc. with the lab-based learning to provide enhance a higher level reasoning skill. But if it is required, exploring the effectiveness of lab assignment for achieving its goal, we should be clear about the aim of each assignment, learning objective of the assignment, what to do in that assignment, what is the procedure to accomplish the task, and what is the result, etc. In the laboratory, instructor generally tells students to do this, record this, tell me what you observe, and in some cases, interpret what you observe, or they ask, what are the implications of what you observe? Now, in this study, we consider the handout-based learning during the laboratory session and title this activity as the handout-based learning, that is the HBL. So we have designed the handout for various courses like C programming, digital technique, system programming, and the mobile application development course of computer and allied branches. Also, we consider the case study of handout-based learning for the mobile application development and the digital technique course. Now, what is the HBL, or before considering that, what is the handout? So handout is a paper-based resource provided to the student during the laboratory session. So it increases the attention and motivation and helps the student to follow the development of an idea or the argument. In this study, we consider the handout-based learning during laboratory session and title this activity as the handout-based learning. So this HBL is an activity in which the handout for the practical assignments of the course will be given to the student for the assignment completion during the laboratory session. So handout is a guided document used by the learner, which is useful for implementing the problem statement in the lab session. We designed the handout for the courses given in this table. So that is C programming, digital techniques, system programming, and mobile application development. So we conduct the HBL activity for the mobile application development and the digital technique and presented the result and the feedback of using this activity in the laboratory session. Now, C programming course is of paramount importance as this course is a base for all the programming languages like C++, Java, etc. So each handout for this C programming contains the problem statement, learning objective, theory, algorithm, flowchart, program, input, output, practice problem statement, conclusion, and the learning outcome. The handout for the C programming are available on these two sites, or it is also available on the slide share. Now let's consider the example. Like that is the handout for the C programming. So consider here the handout number 6. So in this case, first the assignment or the problem statement is given, that is Write a C program using switch case statement to read the two values from the user and perform the addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and modulus division. Next, we consider the learning objective of this handout. That is, write the syntax of the switch case statement, draw the flowchart for the switch case menu-driven solution, write the algorithm for the switch case menu-driven, then write the program using the switch case statement. Next, we consider the theory related to the switch statement in this handout, then the sample example, then the flow diagram for the switch case, then next the flow chart for the problem statement, that is for the given problem statement, then the algorithm, that is how to write the algorithm for the program. Then the sample program is given. Then what will be the input of this program and the output? So the first student will write this program and execute it. And then the student practice this problem statement. That is, write a program to take the integer from the user and perform the following operation. That is, check whether the number is even or odd. Check whether the number is prime or not. Calculate its factorial and check whether the number is positive or the negative. Then next the conclusion, and then finally the learning outcome of this handout. That is, at the end of this assignment, students are able to write the syntax of the switch case statement, draw the flowchart for the switch case menu driven solution, write the algorithm for the same, and finally write the program using the switch case statement. Now next the handout for the digital technique. Now digital technique is the course of the second year computer and allied branches and electronics and allied branches. This course is also important from the competitive exam point of view, like GATE. Hence the handout for this was designed and used during the laboratory session. Each handout of this course contains aim of the experiment, then the learning objectives, component required to perform the experiment, theory, procedure, and finally the result. So the handout for this course is available on this faculty page as well as on the slide share net. So now consider the example that is here, the handout for study and verify the truth table of the logic gates. So now here first there is an aim, that is to study and verify the truth table of the logic gates. Then next is the learning objective, that is identify various ICs and their specification. Verify the truth table of logic gates like basic gate, universal gates, and the derived gate. Now next part is the component required, means what are the component you require while performing this experiment. Then theory, means what are the different basic gates, then what is the truth table for each basic gate as well as the universal gate and the derived gate. So here the pin diagram is also given for basic gates, then the derived gate and the universal gate. The next procedure, that is how to make the connection. So the procedure is given, and then finally the result. Now next the handout for the C programming. Now, system programming of third year is a core course of the computer science and engineering undergraduate program and is the prerequisite for the course compiler construction. This course consists of the algorithms which are required to be implemented during the laboratory session. So students generally find the lab assignment of this course difficult to implement. Hence, the handout for this course were designed so that students can use this handout as a guideline during the laboratory session. Each handout of this course consists of aim, theory, program or the algorithm depending on the problem statement, input, output, and the conclusion. So the handout of this course is also available on this faculty page as well as the slideshare.net. Now consider the example of this. Now first the aim, that is the scanner using the Lex programming. Then theory related to the Lex, that is written by the LPDT. Then Lex and YAG, these are the two LPDTs. So how the how this LPDT works using the Lex and the YAG. Then now since we are concentrating on the Lex, so here the information about the Lex program is given. How to write the program using that Lex programming. Then how to compile that program. Okay, and then the program is given. Then input, output, and the conclusion. So in this handout, we have given the program. But if we consider the next, that is the suppose handout, that is design and implementation of the pass one of the two pass assembler. So in this case, the aim is given, then theory, that is what about two pass translation. Then what are the tables we need while implementing the assembler pass one. Then algorithm. Now in this case, instead of the program, the algorithm is mentioned. Then the input, means input is the assembly language, and then the output is the intermediate representation of it, and then finally the conclusion. Now next, the handout for the mobile application development. The need of designing and implementing the applications for the mobile devices is ever increasing in the market. In accordance with the projection regarding the requirement of the society and the IT industry, mobile application development course is introduced in the engineering curriculum. Mobile application development is the new course introduced for the computer and the allied branches, and now it is the most popular course among the student, and the course has employability enhancing potential. Since it is emerging technology based course, so it is necessary to emphasize the need of clear understanding of the fundamentals of this course. This course is of paramount importance for the design and development of various mobile applications for the Android platform based devices. Handout design and use in this experiment for teaching the mobile application development course contains practical assignment and second theoretical or the instructional assignment. Practical assignments consist of the assignment statement, design guidelines, screenshots of the expected app, then functionality and the other approaches for the implementation. Theoretical or the instructional assignments consist of topic-based questions, synopsis of the mini project and the mini project presentation and the completion. The handout for this course was designed and available on this faculty page as well as the slideshare.net. Now consider the example of this. Now in this case, the problem statement, that is design and implement a login form app using the Android UI element. So the second component of this handout, that is the design, then the different steps to be followed, then the guidelines, other approaches, and the guidelines to the other approaches, and then finally the references. Now consider the case study. Now the handout, based learning for mobile application development. So the here the learning objective is design and implement the mobile application using modern mobile development tool for Android. A group of 60 students from the BIT class is considered. For assessment, the student performance was measured in terms of number of assignments completed by each student. We use a survey instrument with the Likert scale to collect student feedback to know the student perception about the way the course was taught and about the handout and its use. Learning domain use, that is the Bloom's taxonomy, and it covers, this question covers the cognitive domain, that is apply and create level. A group of 60 students is used for this experiment. Out of 60 students, 30 student group is used as a control group and 30 students group is used as a experimental group. While forming the experimental and the control group, it is ensured that both the groups are validated based on the prerequisite test conducted on the Java programming language. In experimental setup, first, the teacher taught the content from this course in the classroom by experimental teaching method, that is using PowerPoint presentation. Till this, the procedure is same for both groups. The difference is the point where the assignment implementation start. For the control group, the handout is not provided, and for the experimental group, the handout was provided. Student performance was measured in terms of number of assignments completed by each student in every group and through contribution and completion of mini project. It is observed that the theoretical or the instructional assignments were completed by more than 85% student in both groups, whereas the completion percentage of the experimental group was more than the control group for the practical assignment. The students who have completed the assignment based on each topic could apply the knowledge of those during the project implementation. Therefore, it is necessary to make sure that the student complete the assignment or the task designed by the teacher. So we use the factor like task completion, mini project involvement, and a few MCQ tests on the same topic to measure the effectiveness of use of handouts during the experiment. Student in the experimental group performs significantly better than the control group. This table shows the student feedback for the MAD course delivery with the experimental setup and the handout based teaching learning method. The table shows that the 86% students agreed that the use of handout enriched their knowledge and help in the implementation of the mobile application development program. The handout for this course was given to the student at the start of the laboratory session, that is at the start of the digital techniques laboratory session. Student will do the following things in the laboratory session. That is, read the problem statement and try to solve this problem statement. Go through the handout. Go through the learning objective of this experiment. Study the theory part. Solve the logical expression, if any. Draw the circuit diagram and check the same with the diagram given in the handout. Make the connection as per the instructions in the handout provided. Perform an experiment according to the instruction given in the handout. Check the result of the experiment with the result given in the handout. And finally, contact the instructor related to any query. From the feedback, it is found that 100% student agreed that the lab handout provided for this course was helpful. 94% student agreed that the guidelines provided in the lab handout helped them to complete the assignment. 94% student agreed that theory part given in the handout was useful to clear the concept about the experiment. Then 92% student agrees that handout was supportive document to encourage for the accomplishment of the assignment. 94% student agrees that overall handout enrich their interest in the implementation of the lab assignment. 100% student agreed that the handout was useful in writing the laboratory journal of this course. And finally, we can see that this 100% student liked this learning activity. So finally, the conclusion. So this paper explains and improves the use of handout in the teaching learning process. HBL for the mobile application development and the digital technique is explained in detail. The handout design are open educational resources to use for this courses. And these handouts can be incorporated with any ICT tool like Moodle or the faculty or the course webpage. These are the references, and thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. How is this strategy different from manual based learning?
How this strategy is different from?
Manual based learning.
Manual based learning.
Yes, ma'am.
Now here in this study we have designed the handout so student can use it during the laboratory session as a guideline. So naturally it will be useful. In case of the manual, and since these handouts are available on the net, so student can go through it before coming to the laboratory session. Hello?
We will give the audience 2 more minutes in case there are more questions. Are you giving any problems through handouts?
Pardon, sir?
Are you giving any problems through handouts?
Yeah, now in case of the C programming, now in this handout, first the student will try this program given in the handout, and then we have given some practice problem statement. So that student can practice the problem statement using this switch case statement or using the theory part given in the handout. So in case of the C programming handout, we are given the practice problem statement for each and every handout. Like in these case also, that is in case of the one dimensional array. So one program and these are the practice problem statement. So near about 5 practice problem statement we are given.
How is this method more effective than flipped class?
In case now this is related to the laboratory session, and flipped classroom, this is we can use to teach the theoretical topics. So these are 2 totally different methods. And in flipped classroom, we provide the videos to the student. So they will go through that video and then next day discussion on the same topic. But that is not the case with this handout. So these are used during the laboratory session, and flipped classroom, this is generally used in the classroom to teach the theoretical concepts.
Have you set up websites for flipped classroom?
Yes, pardon, sir?
Have you set up websites for flipped classroom?
No, sir, not flipped classroom. No, see, this is my colleague's website, that is Trupti Indi. So on this website, The two handouts are there, that is mobile application lab handout and the C programming. And if you go through my website, then there are the handouts for a database system, then the system programming, then digital techniques, and the C programming. So these sites are generally used to provide the materials to the student. So it is not used for providing the videos for the flipped classroom strategy. But if it is possible, we can create our own videos and then upload it on the site.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for answering all the questions. I'll send you the recording.
Okay. Thank you, sir.